If you're a Game of Thrones fan, you have to watch this video. Stay until the very end because I'm gonna play for you on the cello Game of Thrones. Hello everybody, it's your girl Diva Wendy Queen. Why not make up anymore? Because my channel is now expanding into some really exciting things. So I hope that you'll start checking out some of my other videos after this one. But today we're gonna talk all about Game of Thrones. Comment down below if you are a Game of Thrones fan, because I am. At first I could never get into it, and then finally I got into it, and then I watched all 7 seasons like in, I don't know, a month or so. I know some people did it in a week, but oh my gosh, I just love the characters of Game of Thrones. I love everything about it. So when Urban Decay came out with Game of Thrones makeup and said, would you want to review it? And I was like, heck yeah. Okay, so let's just get right into it. This is definitely for the diehard fan. This is so damn cute. It's like a book. Okay, and when you open it, there's a big mirror here. Check this out. And there's the Game of Thrones. Oh, and then it has like the map and everything. And then when you open this here, there is the palette. Now, this is completely not practical when it comes to like carrying it to travel or anything because it's really heavy. But this is really good. When I did my makeup, I just took this palette out and it's great. Now, this is divided into the 4 houses. It doesn't say explicitly which one's which, but judging from the names, we can safely say that this is the White Walkers. This is definitely House Stark. This is obviously House Lannister because it says King's Landing here. With the dragon in the red, of course, this is House Targaryen. Now, what's really interesting is each palette here, we just call it palette, comes with 4 shades that you can work with. And this here on the side is supposed to be a transformer shade. I haven't tried all of them, but I did use this as a transformer, as you see in my little demo, and I put it in the middle. I have to try the rest and see how they mix together. I'm like a really kind of neutral girl. I don't really play with green or blues too much, so this is not like gonna be my everyday use, but I just love it because this is about Game of Thrones. We are going to do some very quick swatches. This is not a review, just sort of first impression. Urban Decay almost never disappoints. Holy cow. Yeah, this is definitely White Walkers. Look at this shade right there. Woo, silver. That's how that looks like. I am gonna take the Transformer shade and just swatch by itself. That's how that looks like. And I'll swatch it right here. Like so. So it's like almost like transparent. But now let's see what happens when I transform it onto the blue, let's say. Oh. Interesting. All right, let's try the next one, Winterfell. Swatches nicely. This one is unexpectedly not very pigmented, or it's just not the color I expected. This one is called Nymeria, but it swatches well. Now this one, Winterfell, I already used. It's a little bit dusty. See, it's kind of like, it's got big flakes, so just be careful when you use it. But it does look really beautiful, like I love it. So let's transform on this one, shall we? This brown one. It's nice, it just gives it a different texture. But let's do it by itself and swatch it like that. Yeah, these are like basically pretty transparent by itself. House Lannister. King's Landing. Whoa, whoo. Whoa. So let's swatch it on something like this one. Last but not least, we have, oh yes, this one. Oh my gosh, I love those golds. Oh, and the purple is nice too. Oh my gosh, look at this gold. Hello. This looks good on any skin tone. Let's try out the Transformer Bay of Dragons. Again, very dusty, but I guess that's the point for the transforming. Beautiful by itself. Again, pretty transparent by itself. When you put it on top of something, let's try the purple. Ooh, I like. And then we have 2 brushes. I'm kind of freaking out. Aya. Needle, the brush. Of course we know of Aya Stark's needle, her sword. This one, I love so much. What a great idea. Oh, how cute is that? Seriously, Urban Decay. Look at this brush though. I can go like this. Shh. That's what that looks like. Wait, hold on, I'm totally. Oh my gosh, look at this. Look at the front. It's so cute. I love it. You know nothing.
Jon Snow.
Jon Snow's long claw. Okay, by the way, did you guys watch season 8 first episode already? Or maybe by the time you watch this, it's already after. But that scene when all these people just walk in with Emilia Clarke and Jon Snow on a horse walking in like king and queen, I was just like, oh my god. Do you see Sansa giving Dragon Lady a major attitude? Yeah, that was interesting. To me, Sansa is still like season 1, 2, and 3, where she was like this innocent young girl being abused by Cersei, but now she's a powerhouse. She's like, this is my house, and you come here and don't think that you can mess around with my people. It was like that. Anyway, Jon Snow. Jon Snow's sword and brush. Very soft indeed. So let's go over the lipsticks really quickly. This is Cersei Lannister's metallicized lip color. I love this color. I wore it a few times already. It's beautiful. This is White Walker Comfort Matte. That's the one I'm wearing right now. And it is true. It is very comfortable. I was trying to see if I could line it without like a lip liner. It was a little bit difficult. I do suggest a lip liner, especially since this is a comfort matte, which means it doesn't stick to your lips. Daenerys Targaryen Metallicized. Ooh, that's a pretty bright color. I haven't tried this one yet. That's a nice red color. I can see Emilia Clarke wearing that. Sansa Stark Sheer. Yeah, this is definitely pale, kind of like her. This is the lip and cheek stain, and you'll see me demo it. I don't usually use stuff like this because I just don't know like how to blend it well, but it's very natural looking and it blended pretty well. I love the packaging. This is a highlight palette and has 3 shades with a mirror, which is great, and I use this shade in the demo. So I'm gonna swatch these shades real quick for you. Looks like that. And then there's also liners, which is so great. And these are their Urban Decay ones. I think their formula must have improved because it really glides on really nicely. I used this one today and I thought it was gonna be red, but this is actually not. It's kind of a bluish purple with like slight glitter. So it's quite nice and it worked well for my eyes today. This is the Night King. My goodness, the packaging is just so good. Ah, I love it. Ooh, this is metallic blue, but look what just happened. It's so soft that it just broke. So just be careful. This is Lannister Golds. Waterproof. They're all waterproof. I'm not gonna do it as hard now. Oh wow, this is great for like inner corner. Or if you wanna put it on your waterline. That's really beautiful. And this is Winterfell Snow. Ooh, this is like pinkish. Again, great for inner corner right here. Okay, now I'm gonna do the demo for you, the makeup demo, and then side by side, I'm gonna play the cello cover for you. But if you just wanna see the cello cover, I'll link it down below and also up here so you can see the complete cello cover. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Thank you. you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Please do leave a comment down below, and if you haven't already, please subscribe and like this video. Hit that little bell button, always helps me out. And I really appreciate all of your support as I'm transitioning now from not just makeup, but expanding into self-development, self-empowerment, and music, lifestyle, vlogs, travel, everything. And I love to get some ideas from you, what kind of videos you want to see. So thank you so much. Mwah.